Chinese-inspired window art. All my life you've been faithful. I hide my heart in your shadow. So in this video, I'll show you the whole process behind making this window art piece. And I just wanted to say that there probably could have been better ways of doing this, but when I had this idea, I honestly didn't know that this would even work. There was no way to foresee all problems, and I tried to plan as best as I could, but ultimately a lot of this came down to planning as I went. With all that said, this idea actually started in 2016 while visiting Japan. I was so inspired by Asian architecture, especially since it was early in my woodworking experience, and I was noticing a lot about design. But I didn't have the skills, and I didn't know how to incorporate it in my projects. And fast forward 4 years later, me and my wife were on a walk around the neighborhood, and I couldn't help but notice a neighbor's porch with a peculiar design. And that was enough to spark the idea again, and I wanted to make something that reflected my Chinese heritage that would be meaningful. And I am by no means an expert of Chinese history and heritage, but I very much appreciate where I've come from and the generations before me. And the Chinese culture is so incredibly rich with tradition that goes back thousands of years. And sadly, I honestly don't read or write Chinese and had to ask my parents for help for choosing a meaningful character. I also needed to pick something that was at my skill level to put together. So I ended up choosing the character Fuk, which my parents say it could translate to blessing or prosperity. And the design seemed actually pretty doable. And I found this ideal spot to put it, which was close to a symmetrical square. I just needed to make calculations for a circle in the middle, which I did with the help of a YouTube video I referenced below. And I had to cut the circle with a miter saw since I don't have a router or a jigsaw. And for the circle, I wanted something thick, so I took some old 4x4 posts that I had from other projects and used the hand planer to make it more even. Then I had to set my saw as close to 2.64 degrees as I could, which was impossible. And I lined up the saw to cut off 2 7/8 inch pieces. And it was incredibly hard to notice the curve, and even when I cut a few more pieces, it barely looked like a circle at all. But I figured I would keep going, and then it started to look a little bit more like a circle. But unfortunately, when I put it all together, the pieces didn't actually fit, and it was pretty ugly and lopsided. This thing probably needed a level of precision I couldn't achieve. But I wasn't done yet. I had an idea to tape some pieces of cardboard together and measured where the center was, and I used some string and tied it with a marker and drew out a circle. And then I laid down the pieces and ended up needing to take out one piece to make the circle fit better. And here's how it looked like after I put it together, which I was much more satisfied with, although not perfect. There were still some gaps in between, but I was hopeful that it wouldn't be a problem. To join the pieces together, I used painter's tape and wood glue. I had to do these in sections of 6 to 8 pieces at a time because I had to be able to flip and glue them. I will run to you in my direction, and I will trust you. And there were still some gaps which I would deal with later. I removed the tape and needed to sand them down. And afterwards, there was just so much dust. I put it back together and tried to make the spacing even. And to connect them and eliminate the problem of the gaps, I used 1x2 pieces to drill them together. And again, I couldn't do the whole thing all at once because it wasn't sturdy enough to flip, so I had to split the circle in two sections. And then I connected them together. Careful. And here's the gap still. And I was overconfident in this thing to actually roll it, which wasn't smart in retrospect, but cool to watch. And to store it, I braced it against the table I had. The next part was making the Chinese characters. So I measured out the lines and calculated the ratio of this circle and mine's to figure out roughly how long the pieces should be. And it was pretty challenging to match the pieces to some of the curves. I didn't know how else to do this, but I lined up the pieces and marked the angle of the circle on the piece and lined up my miter saw to the line I drew. And I pretty much repeated this process. Sometimes it didn't fit and I needed to recut it. After cutting all the pieces, I put them together mostly by pocket holes and screws. And I actually didn't drill the pieces into the circle yet because I was worried that if I did, I might accidentally break it off when putting up the circle. And this is one of my favorite stains, which I use provincial, and I think it gives it a nice rustic look. And I didn't want it to get ruined by weather or rain since I spent a lot of time on it, so I ended up coating it several times with a satin finish. Because I wanted the characters to be part of the circle, I had to cover up some of the spots before I stained it. The complicated part was having to do it in reverse when flipping the circle around. Then I stained it the same color and avoided the taped areas. I knew the tape wouldn't be perfect and some of it would be blotchy, so I filled in the gaps with a black pen and brown color pencil to clean it up a bit. It might be hard to tell, but some of the parts were more blotchy than this. And before putting on the finish, I realized I should probably label which side was up, down, front, and back, especially since I would be flipping it around so many times. And I propped up the whole circle on 2x4 scraps to allow the bottom to dry better. As I was rolling the circle back and forth multiple times, I think it made some of the parts vulnerable, so I had to repair it by using screws and covered up the holes with wood glue and sawdust. And this is by far one of the most stressful times I've ever had with any project. There's no way I would have done this without the help of my wife. She would help me prop up the circle on the brick wall and hold it in place while I drill in the studs to the wall. And it gets really windy by our place, and I wasn't sure if this thing would knock over.
That's great.
once I clamped it down, I was less stressed, but I was still measuring and cutting out studs as fast as I could. To add to more stress, I've never tried screwing into brick, and this was my first time. My wife got cold because of the wind, or was it the stress? And I can't tell you how relieved I was from all that stress. And here's a close-up of drilling into the brick. I bought these screws from Amazon. And the brick wasn't perfectly even, so I used some scrap wood to fill in the gaps. And I screwed in two bracings per side, per corner. And there was a gap to one side, but fortunately a 2x4 fit really well to fill it in. And here's after I drilled in all the bracings, but I wanted the bracings to blend in with the color of the circle and the Chinese characters. So I used painter's tape to help stain it better. But for the bracings that didn't need staining, it looked awkward and I wanted the circle to pop out more, so I made a thin white stripe to outline the circle even more. I removed the tape, and it wasn't perfect, but I was fine with it. After that, just something didn't seem right about the sides. The bracings, they just seemed to be floating out of nowhere. So I decided to outline the whole thing with 2x3 pieces. And after that, it still didn't look right to me. I definitely wanted to do something about the top and the bottom. And here's a landline for outside. And so I used these fence wood pieces I got on clearance and thought the different colors would look pretty cool for an inner frame. And so I just glued them in. For the smaller gaps, I just used some scrap pieces. And for the top part, I had to use nails and glue. I searched the earth for something that could satisfy. And at some point during the hammering, a spider fell on my head, and I wondered why. Inside. Oh my. Knees on the floor, I finally found everything I needed. And for the sides, I just used wood glue and tape. And up my eyes. And I never knew anything was forever till I found. To secure the posts even more, I screwed in a 2x3 piece in between them. And the next day after I glued in the pieces was a pretty significant day, August 16th, the evening before where everyone was waking up from a lightning storm that came out of nowhere after a really hot weekend. And I wanted to check on my circle to see if it was okay after the rain, and surprisingly the rain stopped short about 3 to 4 feet away and it was dry. And then I removed the tape and still ended up putting water protectant over the frame since our area does get a lot of fog and moisture. And I didn't like the bottom brick a whole lot, and I had this vinyl covering from a previous project that I figured I could use. And I made a frame for it to fit under the circle. And the very last step was putting the characters on the circle. I used a tri-square to make sure it was level for the pieces. And as I was putting it together, I realized the pieces didn't quite match, and I think this could be from the fact that the shape was different on the floor compared to the weight of gravity flattening it a bit when it was upright. With these mistakes, there was no turning back at this point, and I just ended up using 1x2s to directly screw into the circle and the characters. And after all of that, here is the final product. All in all, I am still really proud of this project. Like I mentioned earlier, I wasn't even certain that this would actually work. And it is probably one of my most elaborate woodwork projects I've ever done, which took a lot of planning and improvisation. And I even got some compliments pretty soon after I put it up. Thanks, bud. And I don't know what feng shui would have to say about this, as you can read the symbol from the inside. Would that mean our blessing leaves the house? But as a follower of Christ who doesn't believe in those things, maybe it could be a symbol of how Christ has blessed us, so we are to go out and bless the world. The circle isn't perfect, and there were a lot of mistakes along the way, but it's still the best I could do with the skills that I have. So if you like the video, give it a thumbs up if you like, subscribe if you want to see new content, and we'll see you next time.